So this is a review of a solar battery trickle charger. This is a battery tender brand, so it's kind of a known brand. And I picked this up off Amazon, and I went with this battery tender brand one because it's a recognizable brand and it seems to be pretty well reviewed. And a lot of the other solar panels out there for keeping batteries trickle charged don't necessarily have a built-in charge controller, so this one's a little bit more expensive, but it looks like it's a ready-to-go out-of-the-box solution that I don't have to get a separate voltage regulator and all those other things that you have to do with some solar panels. So here's the box. I got the big one that they have. As you can see, it's pretty long. Gives some rough dimensions down here. And came in a big old Amazon box, you can see over there. So this is it. I got it out, pulled it open. What do you get in the box? Well, you get this solar panel. Battery tender brand. You see it's flickering a little bit there. My internal lights are trying to make it come on a little bit. And with it, you get a little bit of wire. One of these kind of standard power connectors. I don't remember what these are called. RC3 maybe, something. I don't remember. But you get that. Fuse. And some alligator clips. And they do show that they optionally sell some different power leads, like a 12-volt cigarette lighter plug-in if you want to reverse charge that way, or even an OBD2 adapter reverse charge, so you can plug it into your OBD2 adapter and feed some power back into it if you don't want to clamp it onto a battery. So there's a solar panel. It's a pretty good sized solar panel. It's big enough that I can get a decent bit of amperage out of it, but also I'll still be able to set this up on the dash of the vehicle I want to use to keep trickle charged. So this will be inside on the dash, out of the weather, and I'll have to move it when I want to drive it so it doesn't go flying around, but it's mostly about just keeping the battery trickle charged so it's ready to go when I do want to drive the car. Now, I've done some math for you here. The area is 12 and a half inches this way, and that's the visible area in here, the part that actually charges. So that's 12 and a half inches. The actual outer dimensions are a little bit bigger. What the box says is 14, and that's about right at the widest point. But, you know, I'm more concerned with what the actual surface area here is because I'm trying to figure out how much power I can get out of this. So anyways, so 12 and a half by 35, long dimension. So that's a total of 437.5 square inches. Now, because this is America, we're using inches, but because I'm an engineer, I want to use the SI system. So 437.5 inches is 0.282 meters squared. The solar radiation incident, when I'm checking in and doing this, on December 16th at 11 in the morning, is 444 watts per square meter. And that's data I got from the Colorado State University Atmospheric Weather Station. And they have all sorts of great data, and you can pull up information whenever you need it. And so for the time of the year, and on a very clear day, that's about what we're getting here in Colorado. So, 0.282 square meters times 444 watts per meter squared. This is your classic dimensional analysis. I should be able to get 125.2 watts of solar radiation incident on this panel. Now, if that's the case, and that's how many watts we're getting, knowing that we're running roughly a 12.5 volt or 12.4, 12.6, somewhere in there battery for an odd mode battery, I rewrite my power equation, P equals IV, as I, current, equals power divided by voltage. So 125.2 watts times 12.4 volts. I should be able to get 10.1 amps out of this at 12.4 volts. Now, I'm not going to get that because solar panels are something like 10% efficient. So I'm expecting about a tenth of this. Or maybe it's 15% efficient. I don't know. We'll see what this one actually does, but I'm not going to get 10 amps out. That'd be awesome if I could, but I'm not going to get 10 amps out. So what I'm going to do, now that you've seen the math, and you've seen the solar panel, is I'm going to go take this outside, set it up. I'm going to try to get a good angle on the sun. The sun's very, very low in the sky right now because it's almost the shortest day of the year. I'm going to set that up, and I'm going to see how much power I can get out of it. I've got a couple multimeters. One, we're gonna watch the actual voltage. So that'll be our voltage term there. And then I'm gonna look at the actual current. I have an amp clamp to watch the current, which has pretty good resolution. Should be able to read down to 0.1 amps. And so from that, we'll get an idea and see how many watts this thing's actually putting out. And see if it really does what it claims it does. So there it is. Let's go do some testing. All right, so I'm doing some investigation with the solar panel out now. You can see I got it all set up to test here on the Jeep. There it's sitting out on the ground, propped up at what I'm approximating to be the ideal angle to the sun. It's pretty approximate though, I can't tell you for sure. I could probably do that a little bit more scientifically than sitting it on the ground with a wheel. But I think that's good enough for just checking out this solar panel. So I've got the battery voltage reading there, 12.64 volts. I've got the amp clamp on the positive lead of the charge controller output. So it's supposed to regulate voltage to something, about like 12 volts. I'm not sure if it pushes more than 12 or what. I would hope so, but I haven't been able to tell yet. So here, let me get this out and see. I've got 12.64 and 0. Let me hook this up. Struggle with it because I'm doing this one-handed. Okay, it's clamped. If you can see that. So I've got 1 amp, pushing about 1 amp right now. All right, so it's in the sun about as direct as I'm ever going to get it. Ideal situation. If you just had it on your roof or something, you wouldn't get this much. And it's able to charge at an amp. What I can't say right now is that charge controller, if it's doing anything, because it knows my battery voltage is pretty good and it doesn't need to push more than an amp. So there's some questions there. If I had a battery that was a little bit more dead, lower on voltage, exactly what it'd be doing. But this is a very good topped off battery. I just drove around, did my grocery shopping. So it's pretty well charged. Now, right now, this is December. This is about as short as the days get. We're closest to the shortest day of the year. And the sun, it's a nice, bright, sunny day. You can see we don't really have any clouds in the sky. A few trees getting close to being in the way. So this is a nice, sunny day. It's a good day for testing. According to the surface area of the solar panel and what the solar radiation is now, based off of the CSU weather station, I should be pulling maximum 8.6 amps. Right now it's doing 1 amp. So that means that this thing right now is a little bit less than 10% efficient compared to my ideal. Now, how much that's gonna change with me fixing the exact angle and everything, there's some efficiency there. But basically, just because I'm calculating out that I should be able to push 9 amps right now, or whatever that is in watts, doesn't mean it's actually going to happen. So this panel is advertised as a 15 watt solar panel, which I think means I should be getting, you know, not too far off from what I'm at. Let's see, 15 divided by, let's say, 12.6. So it's saying that in theory you should be able to get 1.2, and I'm pretty close to that right now. Let's see, let me play with this a little bit. Point it upright some more, see if that does anything. Oh, 1.1, look at that. Little angle change, a little more upright. Oh, back to 1. Let's try to lay it down flat and see what happens. Just set it on the wheel there. Ah, look at that. 0.3. Just goes to show you how much that angle makes a big difference. The cross-sectional area is just so different when it's pointed like this. Things are bouncing off. Let me do it. Let's do it with a shallow angle like I might want for summer. 0.8. Well, that's pretty close. Let's go back upright a little bit more. That's pretty upright. Probably even more than needs to be for the sun angle, but okay, back to 1 amp. 1.1. So there you go. Not too far off from what the panel says it'll put out, which again should be a little over what we've got right now, but that's pretty good. So yeah, really the maximum you're ever going to get out of this is an amp, but right now with the low sun, everything, if I were to set this out and use it to keep battery topped off, and it was flat on a roof or something, if it was on the roof of your RV, 0.3 amps, I mean, that's something that'll keep it trickle charged, you know, kind of topped off, but it's certainly not going to be recharging the battery if you ran one down. So, yeah, interesting stuff, interesting findings. Looks like they're not lying when they say that it's a 15-watt charger. It's just that's 15-watt under the very, very ideal best conditions ever. So, all right, interesting stuff. Let's see what happens when I hook it up to a deader battery. So I have the solar panel hooked up to a basically dead battery. This is out of one of my Nissans. It sits for a long time and I don't drive it for a few months, and then the battery's dead because it's got a slight draw from the security system. So that's why I've got this battery tender. As you can see, I've got it hooked up and the voltage is kind of bouncing around funky. It's actually starting to do a little bit more from when I first grabbed it. It was just basically totally dead. Oh, I've actually got 12 volt reading, but when I first powered this up, it was reading 5. You see it's bleeding down. So if I go back and I hook up the solar panels back on it. So I got the solar panel set up. I should be able to push about 0.9 amps. As you can see, the voltage is really fluctuating around quite a bit. You know, there's a voltage controller in there. But it is putting out some voltage, definitely higher than 12, which is good. We need to push the voltage up. You see the current's kind of shifting around. So on my good charged up battery in the Jeep, I was getting 0.9, 1 amp, something about like that, with how the panel's set up. Now I'm reading about 0.2, 0.3 voltages, fluctuating quite a bit, so it's trying to charge it. Seems like it has issues. When I first hooked it up and the voltage was around 5, I hooked up a jumper pack, this guy, just to push the voltage up, and then it kind of kicked in and recognized that it was there. It was cutting on and off a lot with the totally dead battery, and then having that jumper pack hooked up, I was able to get it to read 12 and push a little voltage into the battery. Now it seems like the solar charger's finally seeing about 12 volts, so it's starting to regulate and do its job. I suspect the longer I leave it on here, it'll settle down. You see already it's bouncing a little less. So leave this here for a little bit and see what happens with it. And I'm not going to be charging up this battery quick. It was just totally dead, but maybe the voltage will stop fluctuating so much. All right, we'll see what happens.